أيضا. With pranams at the lotus feet of Swami, dear brothers and sisters, these are the details published in the month of October 2001. Somehow it slipped our attention, but as I was referring the back numbers, I could find out this was not covered. So we are dealing those are the aspects relating to the episodes. Yes. That day Bhagavan was so busy with Balvikas children from London. Around 1500 children came to see Bhagavan and visit this place. And Swami allowed them to stage a program, a cultural program. This had happened in Vrindavan. And the children from London staged a drama depicting the life of great saints from the state of Karnataka, Andhra, and from epics. They sang number of songs composed by Kanakadasa, K-A-N-A-K-A-D-A-S-A, Tyagaya, T-H-Y-A, G-A-Y-Y-A, Tyagaya, and also the devotion of a great character by name Markandeya, M-A-R-K-E-N-D-A-Y-A, Markandeya. Then Kanakadasa, Tyagaya, Markandeya, the songs and their lives have been so beautifully depicted, have been so wonderfully enacted on the dais in front of Bhagavan. And then Swami was speaking about their performance on the very next day. See their devotion. They come from such a long distance like London and staging a drama in front of Swami, bringing all the dresses, the backdrops, the makeup material, all the way from London. Look at their devotion. And what is interesting now is, Bhagavan made a special mention of the Balavikas teacher in charge of London Balavikas centers. I think that lady is very much here. And Bhagavan made a special mention of her devotion, of her leadership qualities. Bhagavan said, see that lady, the Balavikas guru from London, she is a very noble lady. She is an ardent devotee of Bhagavan. She has learnt all the message of Bhagavan's teachings. And she is practicing them. She could face all the problems in life. She could resist all the difficulties in life. Still hold on to Bhagavan with all the courage. And Swami said, you know what happened? Last time, when she was going back to the airport on her way to London, she got the news of the demise of her husband. She didn't break down. She didn't cry. But she, along with Balavikas children, traveled all along, went to London, and she did what she was expected to do by way of last rites, everything that has to be done. And here Swami says, please let's note this point, that Balavikas guru from London knew pretty well that death is certain. When there is birth, there is bound to be death, inevitable. But death should not shake anybody. They should not lose their faith in God. So, without giving any chance for depression or frustration or hopelessness, she could face all the problems in life and yet she could proceed with Sai's message and mission. She is really a great lady. That's what Swami said about her. But turning towards all of us, sarcastically, he remarked, great devotees are more from women. Comparatively speaking, men are not that great as women. Okay, I see. Swami, is that so? Yes. Then please excuse me, Swami. If there are more women who are devoted than men, I say the mistake lies with creation. Srushti. Srushti. S-R-U-S-H-T-I. Srushti. Mistake lies with Srushti. The divine God will not keep quiet. He turned and then said, nothing wrong with Srushti, creation. Mistake lies with you, with your drushti, the vision. Drushti, D-R-U. S-H-T-I. Drushti. The mistake lies with your vision. Nothing wrong with Srushti or creation. Oh, but still, I don't want to keep quiet because I should champion the cause of men at least. Having been given a chance to represent, how can I keep quiet? Then I said, softly, prayerfully, and respectfully, my Lord, men are less devoted, according to you, on genuine grounds, on some valid reason. Swami said, what reason, what reason? Swami, the only reason is, men have many responsibilities. They have many avocations, many responsibilities. Swami immediately said, what responsibilities? Women have greater responsibilities than men. They take care of homes, they take care of the children, they take care of the husband, maintain accounts. What? Women carry more responsibilities than men. Alright, Swami, last point. Men have more avocations. What avocations? Swami said, what avocations? Going to clubs, playing cards, watching TV cross-legged, asking wife to serve him hot coffee? What avocations? No. Then Baba said, the heart of a man is so hard, like a stone. It has to be chiseled. Then I could know my limitation. Then I said, Swami, if you start chiseling the hearts of men, we'll break to pieces. Please, Swami, please, don't do that. We may be reduced to a powder if you do that. Swami said, no. You have to be broken to pieces, not into a powder. That episode ended. Now we come to the next episode. Devotees from Germany staged a drama there in Bangalore, Vrindavan, in front of Swami. We have a character of a queen by name Elizabeth. And that lady, Elizabeth, sacrificed all her lot. She spent her life in service to humanity. Not only that, she brought from the streets the poor and the needy and the handicapped to the palace. And she served them there. She served them there. But alas, the very same people who were benefited by her harmed her. They have chopped off her hands, cut off their hands. She was deceived. She was betrayed by those whom she has helped. That was the thing. Next day, Swami was commenting on the German presentation. Have you seen the drama? Have you heard the dialogues? Germans, the devotees from Germany, they have written all drama with full of Sai teachings, full of Swami's message. You fellows, do you know that teaching? Mm-hmm. See those people from Germany, how devoted they are. That's what he said. And then he said, the drama presented by the devotees from Germany is so interesting, you know. Why? It has come from the heart. Whereas you fellows, only art. Art is outside, heart is inside. Because it is all a presentation from the bottom of the heart, it was so interesting. That's what Bhagwan said. Okay, Swami, it is London, German season. Okay. And then he went on praising them. See how they were changing. One scene after another scene, in quick succession. They didn't delay. They didn't take time. Immediately they were shifting, changing scene to scene. Did you understand that? What Bhagwan said. Also, they did it quickly. But you do it with all tricks. That is quick. This is the trick. Our boys' presentation is full of tricks. Whereas those Germans. Okay, Swami, it's all right. And finally he said, they did it like that because of their interest. Whereas you fellows, you are always in rest. Theirs is interest. Yours is always in rest. That's how he said. Okay, Swami. That's the episode. Then we go to the next episode of Vinayaka Chaviti Festival. You all know the Vinayaka Chaviti Festival is the first festival in a calendar year. And Vinayaka Chaviti is the worship of the deity of knowledge, the deity of wisdom, Lord Ganesha. And third day, what people do is, they take all these idols, statues in procession and immerse in waters. You must have known that. You must have seen that grand function. Students from all institutions bring idols of Vinayaka. Dancing, singing, oh, nicely decorated. And Swami will go to every group, will have photographs with them, break coconuts there, cheer them up, will bless them, ask them to go in procession to Chitravati, where all the idols are immersed. That is immersion ceremony on the third day after Vinayaka Chaviti is an interesting festival. And that day, I want to share with you what had happened. Swami came out. Most of the boys are there close to Chitravati, immersing Ganesh idols. Swami in the meantime started talking to primary school children. He went on asking them to make speeches. One boy after another boy, thada thada, they went on giving speeches. Very interesting. Without preparation, without advance notice, one child after another child started making speeches. At that moment, I returned from Chitravati, finding that veranda is free, I sat at my usual place. Our mischievous God saw me from a distance. Then he wanted to convey the message. he will see that the message is conveyed at the right time, in the presence of everybody. And then what happened was, he called primary school children. He started putting questions. What is the first question? Hey boy, where do you come from? The boy said, from you, Swami. Swami turned to us and said, if I put that question to you, you will say, from Hyderabad, Swami. From Bombay, Swami. See? See the boys? From you, Swami. That is their devotion. And then second question, he asked the another boy, boy, what is the form of God? The boy said, Swami, love, Swami. See that? You MA, MSc boys, if I ask you what is the form of God, Rama, Krishna, see the boy says, love is the form. He went on teasing, asking those questions and just went on teasing us. Then Baba asked another boy, how do you love God? How do you love God? That boy said, Swami, the best way to love God is to love all and serve all. Are you see? Can you give those answers? See those gentle boys. And then he asked another boy, hey boy, who is your friend? That boy said, Swami, you are my friend. Are boys, would you say that? He'll say, another sir, he is my friend, Swami, he is my friend. See, who is your friend? God is your friend. See how that nicely that boy is giving answer. And then Swami asked another boy, oh ho, God is your friend. All right, you tell me, who is your enemy? Who is your enemy? That boy said, Swami, anger is my enemy. He looked at me and said, do you give that answer? Swami, I can't, I am sure. That boy is great, okay. And then he looked at another boy. Hey boy, what is the way to immortality? What is the way to immortality? That boy said, removal of immorality is the way to immortality. See the standard of our boys. He was very, very happy. And then he asked another boy, hey boy, what is the meaning of namaskar? I think you all know, namaskar is joining both the hands as per Indian tradition to as a sort of reverence and respect to elders, we join both hands. That's called namaskar. Swami asked that boy, boy, what is the meaning of namaskar? You know, that boy said, Swami, na ma, na ma, namaskar, na ma, not mine, not mine. That is the meaning. Oh, what does it mean? Everything is thine, not mine, Swami. See the boys, right? College boys should learn from these boys. See what nice answers they were giving. That had happened that day. And then, the episode did not end there. He went and asked, boy, how many marks you got? 85. How many got? 100. How many marks? 90. Oh. Did you get those marks? No. See, our boys. And then one boy came slowly and whispered into his ear something we could not hear. Then Swami looked at me and said, Anil Kumar, what is that boy said to me? What is that he said to me? Swami, how can I say? He whispered in your ear. I did not hear anything. I don't know what he said. No. Do you know what he said? What do you feel? What do you think that he might have said? I said, Swami, that boy must have got low marks. When everybody got 90s and 80s, that fellow must have felt very much shy. So he didn't want to say loudly. He must have whispered into your ear, low marks he must have got. He said, what nonsense you are speaking. No. He got 100%. He told me in my ear, Swami, I got 100. But I don't tell loudly. Why? Ego may develop in me. Ego may rise its hood any time. Therefore, I don't want to see that. Oh, Swami, very great, very great. And then I said, Swami, I am also happy to note and report to you the standard of English of Sri Satsai Primary School is very high. They speak very good English, I know. There ended the episode on that day. And the next day, Swami started distributing new clothes to all the teachers. I didn't understand why he was doing. It was not a festival day. Why did he distribute new clothes? I have put a question mark face. He said, why do you look like that? Swami, there is no festival. I don't know why you are distributing clothes. Baba said, every day is a festival here, understand it. You don't have to wait for a festival. Every day is festival in Prashantanilayam. Every day is celebration in Prashantanilayam. That's what Bhagavan said. It's very much true. We find 200 from Iran coming. We find 300 to 400 from Russia coming. We find 600 coming from London. Large number of people coming from different places. We also find people coming on motorcycles, driving motorcycles all the way. We find people coming here by walk, thousands of kilometers. Every day is a festival in Prashantanilayam. Then, next episode, Swami looked at a gentleman, very elderly man. He was writing something on paper. Swami said, come on, what is it you are writing? Swami, I am writing an article. Show me. Swami, it's not a fair copy. It's only rough copy. It's not worth showing to you. Then Bhagavan said, why? Swami, I have written in small letters. Bring it, doesn't matter. Ants are small, but they are very powerful. Before you sit, watch whether they are ants or not. Ants are very powerful, they may be small. Doesn't matter, even they are small letters. Come on, bring that book. And he has seen. This elderly man should have kept quiet. Because before Swami, more silent we are, better it is. Because we go wrong somewhere or other. This elderly man said, Swami, there's a lot of discipline among ants. But as I was telling you every time, Swami's is the last word. He turned behind and said, oh, the ants have high discipline, you say. But you don't have to learn from them, he said. He learned from those ants what discipline is. That's what Bhagavan said. Next episode relates to what Bhagavan said on the very next day of Onam festival. O-N-A-M. Onam is a festival which is celebrated here in Prashantanilayam every year in the month of August by the devotees from Kerala. Next day, Bhagavan was commenting on their celebration. Kerala is a land of culture. If any beggar stands at the doorstep, he will never be turned away. Whatever lot they have, the housewives serve them food. And all Kerala has high respect for classical music. But people say politicians are atheists. Politicians have no faith in God. That is all politics. So far politics are concerned, they have no faith in God. But individually, they are great devotees. For political purposes, they are atheists. But in their individually lives, they are great thieves. That's what Bhagavan said. Then he went on describing a drama, Mohini Bhasmasura, enacted by the devotees from Kerala. Mohini Bhasmasura. Well, this Mohini Bhasmasura, a beautiful drama. I will put it like this so that you will appreciate it. Bhasmasura is a modern man, a demon. Mohini is nature, enchanting world, attractive world. The man Bhasmasura is attracted by Mohini, M-O-H-I-N-I, the woman, so beautiful, representing nature. Beautiful woman is the nature, by name Mohini. The man Bhasmasura is attracted by Mohini. So much attracted that he has forgotten God. And ultimately he wanted to harm God also. Then Mohini attracted more and more. And Mohini started dancing. This fellow also started dancing. He got a boon from God, according to which, on whomsoever he lays his hand on the head will be burned to ashes. So Bhasmasura was keeping his hand on everybody. So they were burned to ashes. That was the boon he got from God. Well now, Mohini started dancing. This fellow also started dancing. While dancing, she kept her hand on her head. This fellow also kept his hand on his head, burnt ashes. So man, in his excessive desire, man in his enchantment towards the world, man because of his excessive attraction towards the world, gets burnt. That is the message of this drama presented. And Bhagavan explained it so nicely and neatly. You know, Bhagavan said, the whole world is managed by three qualities. One, the animal quality, tamasic, T-H-A-M-A-S-I-K. The second, emotional quality, rajasic, R-A, J-A-S-I-K. And third, sattvic quality, S-A-T, W-I-K. Sattvic, the piousness. So, the world is managed by three. Tamasic, rajasic, sattvic. The inertia, the emotion, and the piousness. Swami said, music requires three. One is Shruti, the correct tuning. The raga, Shruti, the wavelength. Raga, the tone. Tala, the beat. All the three are necessary for music. For the whole world to sustain, the three basic qualities are necessary. And communicating in the same wavelength. On the greatness of the state of Kerala, Swami went on mentioning the name of a king by name Sibi, S-I-B-I, and also mentioned the name of another emperor by name Bali, B-A-L-I. Well, And he also made a mention of another king, Bhishma, B-H-I-S-H-M-A. They are all the kings of sacrifice. They are all the kings of penance. They are all the kings of truth. They are the kings of eternal values. They all belong to the state of Kerala. He went on praising them. And then, I move on to the next episode. They kept a very comfortable chair on the dais for Swami. Swami immediately asked, "Who brought this new chair?" Then, before he takes to task any boy, because you cannot do anything with his, without his permission, so I intervened, "Swami, the chair is very good, very beautiful to look at. The chair must have been brought here so that it will be very convenient and comfortable for you." Immediately Baba remarked, "Comforts and conveniences are for you. I am beyond. I don't want these comforts and conveniences. I can bear any problem." No, nothing. And then, next episode, about 300 Muslims came from this nearby village by name Bukkapatnam, 300. And Swami built a school for their children there in that school long back. Muslims came here with a special prayer. Swami went, "What do you want?" "Swami, you constructed masjid for us." "Thank you." "Acha." "Swami, you constructed school for our children." "Very good. Now what do you want?" "Swami, we want a community hall, Shadi Khana, where we can perform marriages of our people. We want a community hall to perform marriages of Muslim community." Swami said, "Done. You go back. I'll give instructions to the engineers. They'll start construction. Tomorrow itself, be happy." That's what Bhagwan said. I should tell you, the lotus feet of Bhagwan attracts people of all religions, of all faiths, of all nations, of all age groups. That is his divinity. That is divinity. I said, "Swami, it is fantastic. How you attract people of all religions? Unbelievable." You know what Baba said? "Whatever differences you have to drop them out at the gate and then enter into Prashantinalaya. The moment you get in, only unity, differences outside. All should be one, like brothers and sisters." That's what Bhagwan said. Before I close this month's episode, let me end with a note that brotherhood of man and fatherhood of God is the quintessence of the message of Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba. Now I pass on to the other episodes. Well, this was recorded in the month of October 2000. That day, Swami was talking to some devotees from Croatia. Most of the people also here have not heard of the name of that country, Croatia. Croatia. We don't know where it is located. If you just place in front of me the world map, I'll be a successful failure. Well, I don't think. And Swami gave them interview and came out of the mandir, walked gently and slowly, stood in front of us and started telling about them. You know who they are? Swami, I don't know. There are the devotees from Croatia. Oh, I see, Swami. What is speciality? After all, people from all over the world come here. What is special? He said, what you know? You seem to be a fool. Swami, why do you say I seem to be a fool? I am a fool. Not seem to be a fool. Then Swami went on explaining. You know, all those Croatians, they made a trip to this place, saving money every month from their salaries. The hard-earned money saved every month is accrued, and with that money they made a trip to this place. They came from a long distance, spent money. Swami said, I should also tell you another thing. What is it, Swami? And Bhagavan said, watching all the Croatians coming here, saving money like that, bearing all the difficulties and suffering, one rich man wanted to finance them. He came and said, why do you worry like that? Why do you struggle hard? I'll pay the money for many people. I'll pay the money. Don't worry. Don't worry. Swami, whatever a nice thing it is. Swami said, that's why I said you are a fool. Why, Swami, what happened? The Croatians told that rich man, sir, we don't want your money. Swami will not appreciate if we take money like that, collect money like that, and make a trip to this place. So thank you very much for your generosity and for your kindness. That's what they said. That is the standard of devotion of devotees from Croatia. Well, I don't know about others. I felt very much, very much humiliated. Because most of us don't stand anywhere near them in respect of their high standards of devotion. Then maybe Swami said all this for us to learn. Now I take you to another episode. Prime Minister of Nepal, by name Koirala, then visited this place. And today we have another Prime Minister. I'm speaking of the Prime Minister of Nepal of those days, Nepal. And Swami granted them interview to all the members of Koirala, everybody. And Swami, after saying bye to them, came to us and stood in front of us. What did he say? Hey, Anil Kumar, you know him? You saw him? Shall I say yes? You will say, are you here to see everybody? Can I say I did not see? Then what happened to your eyes? So I kept quiet. Swami, I want to know from you. Then he said, he's Prime Minister from Nepal. Oh, I see, Swami. Very good. Swami, I want to know what happened there. In the interview room, please let me know. Swami said, you know, there in the interview room, Prime Minister told Swami this way, Bhagavan, how lucky are these boys? How lucky are these people? They see you every day. They see your lovely form every day. They are very lucky. They see you morning and also in the evening. They are very lucky. But we people, the administrators, the people at the helm of affairs, cannot afford to travel. We don't have time. We have got pressing engagements and appointments. But these people are so lucky to see you every day. And the Prime Minister further added, Bhagavan, how lucky will I be. If I become a child right now, to get a seat in your primary school, how lucky will it be if I become a child at this moment and get admission in your primary school. Swami said, see what he said. Everybody laughed. That was the height of his devotion as the Prime Minister of Nepal. Then Baba consoled him, laying his hand on his back, said, look here, Koirala, why do you worry? Why do you feel so sad that you are not able to visit me frequently? It's not the number of trips that are important. It's not the number of trips that is important. No. Your feeling, your yearning, your prayerness, your prayerfulness, your love for Swami, they are more important than the number of trips that you make to this place. You have total bliss, is it not? That is enough. That's what Swami said. And then, this Koirala, Prime Minister of Nepal, wrote there in the visitor's book, having gone to that super specialty hospital, he wrote in the visitor's book this way, this hospital and the people of this land enjoy the benedictory blessings of Guruji. Guru is preceptor, as you know. Guruji. And Swami asked him in the interview room, why did you say Guruji? Why did you write like that? Who is your Guru? Then Koirala said, Swami, you are my Guru. But as your devotee, I should be very humble. I should not spell out your name loudly, such as Sai Baba. No, no, no. I call you Bhagavan. I say Swamiji. I say Guruji. But I don't call you by name Swami. Swami said, see, that is their devotion. His devotion is so great that they don't want to address Swami by name. They call him Bhagavan, my Lord. That is their devotion. With that, we come to an end of that month episodes. Now I take you to the next month, reported in August 2000, Telugu Sanatana Sarathi. August 2000, yes. Swami was smiling and walked and sat on the chair. But how can we ask Swami, why do you smile? Can you ask? We can't ask. So we too started smiling. No one knew why everyone was smiling. No one. And then Baba said, you know, one gentleman is to speak tomorrow on the subject information to transformation. He is going to speak to you tomorrow on this subject. Oh, Swami, it's a very nice subject, Swami, I said. Is there anything wrong? Nothing wrong. It's a good subject. Information to transformation. But Baba said, there will never be transformation through information. Information will never bring about transformation, he said. That is the topic on which this man is going to speak next morning. On his face he is telling, oh Swami, if information is not going to bring about transformation, how to achieve transformation? Then Baba said, transformation is possible only by practice, not by information. Oh, and information without practice is useless. Leave alone transformation. So information should take you to practice, and the practice will bring about transformation. That's what Bhagavan said. Then now I move on to the next episode. Bhagavan gave an interview to a very big chief minister, I believe. A man well experienced in politics, chief minister of some state. And Swami came out of the interview room and said, "Just now I gave interview to the chief minister. You must have noticed. Swami, what did you tell him?" He said, "Why are you interested? Why are you interested?" "Swami, I want to know. Because whatever you speak is a message to the humanity. So if you don't mind, if I am not mistaken, please let me know." Baba said, "I told Chief Minister in clear cut terms that the country should stand united. You should not break your country into pieces on linguistic basis, on regional basis, on silly considerations like caste and community. No, the country should always stand united. It should never be divided on silly grounds." That's what Baba said to the chief minister. And Swami also said, "Further, I told him, look here, chief minister, the whole body is one. And it acts unitedly. You cannot cut off hands. You cannot chop off legs. You cannot behead and separate parts. And that's useless. You are killing the person. So, the whole country is a body, single body. Don't break it into bits." That's what Bhagavan said. It's really a very good lesson to all politicians. When the country stands united, the country will be strong. And Baba gave an example. When threads are separated, easy to cut with a little finger, but all the threads interwoven, made into a cloth, you cannot break it. You cannot cut it. Am I not right? So, a strong nation cannot be conquered, cannot be defeated. So, unity is the strength. That's what Bhagavan said. Then, I move on to the next episode. One MBA boy gave a talk, a short speech in front of Bhagavan, and Swami commanded him to make a speech. And then, Swami started speaking about that boy. "Anil Kumar, you know him? But I want Swami to speak more. I know him, I see him every day. But I cannot say I know him. I want Swami to speak." Then they said, "Swami, not intimately. Not intimately. I have been seeing him every day." Then Swami said, "Look here. He has been with us for the last 17 years. He is our student right from his primary school." "Oh Swami, that's so. When this boy was studying in the primary school, he used to look at our university. When I would study there, when I will grow up into a big boy, when I will get admitted to that university, that was his dream. And today, he is a student of this university. And Anil Kumar, you know what he is doing? Now he is looking at that primary school where he studied. Oh Swami, why should we look at that school? Now he is in the university, he can forget about the school." Swami said, "You are wrong. That boy is looking at that school where he studied earlier as an expression of thanksgiving, as an act of gratitude." And then Swami started telling, remember. You should always feel grateful to your parents, grateful to your institution, grateful to elders, grateful to everybody who helped you and brought you up to this present stage. That's what Bhagavan said. And then, this is a lesson, my friends, for every one of us to learn. Swami said this, as the food is served on the plate, you should first offer it to God and then eat. Why? So that all the food that you partake will be free from all impurities, will be free from all adulterated stuff, will become pure, a prasadam, sanctified. But you are not doing it. You offer the food to the demons, not to God. That's what Baba said. Oh, I see. Swami, when you said that, I feel very sorry. Okay, Swami, please explain little more about this. Baba said, you children, you are the plate. You are the plate, and all the food served on the plate of your life are the senses. The senses of perception and the senses of action. And this food of senses must be offered to God. Who is He? Goodness, truth and beauty. Satyam, Sivam, Sundaram. God is truth, goodness and beauty. This food of senses must be offered to that God. But you are not offering. But you are offering this food of senses to demons. Who are the demons here? Anger, lust, greed, hatred, avarice. That's what you are doing. Swami, wonderful, fantastic expression. What a beautiful metaphor it is. You started it as a simile and made it into a metaphor. We are really grateful to Swami. And then, in the meantime, that boy who spoke in the auditorium that morning, he got up, came close to him and took his Pada Namaskar. Please note this point. Swami immediately looked at him and said, why extra Pada Namaskar? Extra why? This morning you did Namaskar to my photo there. Why do you do it now, my friends? What is interesting is this. Bhagavan knows the Pada Namaskar of the boy in the morning. He received his humble salutations offered at his lotus feet in the morning. And he remembers even now and tells, why this extra? I already received it. My friends, when we pray in front of Baba's picture, when we offer our humble salutations to his picture, be convinced that they go to Swami. Be sure that all our prayers are received by Swami. Be sure. This is the lesson. That's the purpose of my writing these episodes in Sanatana Sarathi. After all, his conversation with boys and teachers, why should they be recorded and published? According to me, the gospel of Sai, the teaching of Sai is everyone's property, not the whole soul property of students and teachers. God's teachings has no copyright. Has no copyright. Air. God has no copyright on the air. He gave it to you. Earth. No copyright. We are seated on earth. So, it is in this context. I decided to record everything and share with everybody because it will be preserved for the posterity, and the gospel of Sai will be valued more and more in future. And then, next episode, there is an old man who is a man of tradition. He does worship. Pakka Orthodox man. You must have seen there in the mandir the kind of prayer they do. They keep flowers in front of the picture. And then they say, Bhagavan, I offer my eyes to you. In Sanskrit, netram, netram, samarpayami, 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 I offer my eyes to you, two eyes to you. In the ritual, what they do is, they take a flower, touch both the eyes and put it in front of the photograph. Meaning, I offer my eyes. Swami started joking. You are not offering your eyes. You are offering only flowers. Whereas you say, oh God, I offer both my eyes. But you are offering only flowers. What sort of worship it is? Bogus. Then I didn't want to keep quiet. Time to get clarification. Baba, Bhagavan, what? When I say offer my eyes, should I pluck out, remove my eyeballs and keep it in front of your picture? Is it not sufficient to offer a flower as a symbol? You want both of my eyeballs? What is Swami? I want your guidance in this matter. Baba said, no, no, no. When you say, I offer my eyes to you, it only meant, oh God, let these eyes watch only sacred things of nature. Let these eyes be sanctified. Let my vision be sacred. My eyesight be sanctified. That is the meaning in offering eyes to God. When you offer both your ears to God, Shrotram, S-R-O, T-R-A-M, Shrotram, ear hearing, when you offer to God, doesn't mean that you should cut your ear and offer it to a photograph, no. Oh God, let my hearing be sacred. Let my audition be sacred. Let my ears be sanctified. That is the purpose behind it. Swami, all right. Should I offer every day? Then once my eyes are sanctified, should I offer my eyes to you next tomorrow also? Baba laughed. Aray, you seem to be a businessman. Oh, I see. I am sorry, Swami. But I want to know the inner significance. Baba said, you know, don't you wash vessels every day? Why? To keep them clean. So similarly, you should offer the whole body to God every day. So the whole body will be sacred. That's why you have to pray to God every day. Now I move on to the next episode. Wow. Then, you see boys trying to give letters to Swami every day. Well, we'll be inquisitive to know what they write about. After all, they are unmarried, young fellows. What problems they have? It is understandable if I give a letter. Because I have wife and four children, six grandchildren. What more is necessary for problems in this world? So, I can write my problems and give to God. These boys also give letters. Swami said, Anil Kumar, do you know what they write? When the thought came, immediately he said it. We should be careful about thoughts also. we should be careful about our words, we should be careful about our thoughts, we should be careful of actions. Because everything is registered there in the divine camera. In the divine lens, everything is clicked. Clicked there. So I cannot bluff. So, the thought came to me, what is that these boys write about? And Bhagavan said, you see, thank you my God is one letter. Thank you Baba, you made me write a poem. Thank you Swami, I got first mark in the class. Thank you Swami, I sang in the bhajans. See, innocent hearts. Everything is an offering to Swami. That's what they write. Better you learn how to write a letter to Swami. Okay, Swami, hereafter I'll be careful. Till now I have not written. So from tomorrow, if I am to write, I'll be careful enough. And then Swami suddenly sat and gave a beautiful smile. And said, boys, from tomorrow, I am not going to receive your letters. I am not going to take your letters. Kidding with boys. Then, what should I do? Immediate, Swami, please don't say that. Please take letters. We will have satisfaction of handing over a letter to you. Don't say, Swami, please don't say that. Please accept our letters. Swami said, why? Why? Then I said, Swami, there may be certain situations of emergency. In emergency, we should bring to your notice. We write a letter, Swami. If we don't receive letter, well, our heartbeat stops, my God. My friends, this is going to be a very, very important statement. Please listen to me carefully. What did Baba say? Look, emergency. Note this point. There will be no state of emergency to my devotees. In no time will they feel the situation of emergency. Oh, God is serious. Swami, what does it mean? I don't wait for their letters. I go to them and see that they are rescued. And see that they are saved. There will be no state of emergency in the lives of my devotees. That is Bhagavan, Sri Satsai Baba. That is Bhagavan. Who can say that? And then I go on to the next episode. A very funny thing. Swami, I think this, I don't know whether you heard it or not. Well, Swami started walking and then he stood in front of a student. Materialized a ring for him and got it fit into his ring finger. And then what happened was, that boy was doing like that. I noticed. Swami turned back. What's the problem? Swami, it is very tight. Oh, cut your finger, you can remove the ring. Oh, Swami, very tight. I see. Then Swami touched the finger. And loose now. Swami, loose. Oh, I see. While doing that, Swami stopped there. So, it is neither here nor there, it stopped in the middle. Swami, what? Swami, it is neither loose nor tight, it stopped in the middle. What shall I do? Swami laughed. It's how he plays with boys. Oh, it stopped in the middle? Okay, I'll see. Pakka fit. Now he's okay? Swami, fine. This miracle is important because as he started moving, it was getting loose. At one stage, tight. At another stage, perfect fit. There only, on the finger of the boy. That kind of miracle I did not see before. A correct fit. And then Swami laughed and laughed. Is it okay now? And then he said, boy, what's your name? Swami, my name is Abhay. A-B-H-A-Y. Abhay, meaning fearlessness. Swami said, oh, Abhay, what is the meaning of Abhay? Swami, fearlessness. Oh, fearless? Are you really fearless? Yes, Swami, I am fearless. How to be fearless, Anil Kumar, do you know? Swami, I have a lot of fear. So I cannot give the answer how to be fearless. I have no answer. I have got terrific fear for all cats and rats and all that. I am very much scared of them. So how to speak on fearlessness? Being totally fearful? Swami, I have no answer. Then he said, where there is mistake, there is fear. When there is no mistake, there will be no fear. So Abhay, boy, you are fearless because there is no mistake. And then turned to me and said, it is not enough if you have the name Abhay, fearlessness. But you should have my Abhaya, A-B-H-A-Y-A, Abhaya, blessing, Abhay, fearlessness. You can be Abhay, fearless, with my Abhaya, blessing. That is Bhagavan Sri Sai Baba. So, one can be fearless with divine blessings. That's what he said. I am coming to the last episode for this evening. It was the time of examinations. And suddenly, Swami called warden, come along. There are two sick boys in the hostel. They could not write examination yesterday. However, one boy came and wrote exam today. The other boy could not come. The warden was shivering because he did not inform Swami. Swami, Swami. Array, I know. You don't have to tell me. I know everything. And then looking at me and students, he said, Array, boys, you think Swami is sitting here on the chair? Though I am sitting here on the chair, I look all around. I look all around. I know what's all that is happening everywhere, that you understand me. And then some conversation came. A mention was made about good and bad. Swami immediately remarked, don't say good and bad. To me, all are good. That's what Bhagavan said. Nothing is bad in my sight. No one is bad in my sight. Everything is good. All are good, said Bhagavan. Bhagavan is the embodiment of love. Is the very personification of love. The divine love is beyond good and bad. Divine love is beyond success and failure. Divine love is eternal. Divine love is unconditional. So says Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. May Baba bless you. Thank you. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti. जय बोलो भगवान श्री साई बाबा जी की।